Hey guys, and welcome to Let's Play The Sims 3 Island Paradise Part 25. So, awesome news to get this all started off with. That resort of mine that I built, the second resort that was struggling at first, unfortunately. Well, I got it to open again. It said that we were below $205 profitable. So what I went ahead and did was we made a little extra money from our successful five-star resort, and as you can see I upgraded this, and that basically gave us more rooms. And now that we have more rooms, we can have more people, so more people means more money, and we're open. I know no one's here because it just opened, so yeah. It's kind of dead right now, but hopefully we should pick up soon. I don't understand why there's two employees. Did I even hire maintenance? No. She's just wearing a uniform. Oh, I see. She's changing the food. Huh. I didn't know they had people like that. Interesting. But speaking of maintenance, we have maintenance, I hope. We do. Oh, I could have just gone lower quality maintenance. No wonder it's so expensive. Oh well, whatever. But yeah, so I'm super happy. We finally got the resort back open. I don't have too much money right now, so I'm not going to add too much to it. But I would like to add a little more to the pool, obviously. I'd like to upgrade that more, but I'll wait. Like, that can wait. There's plenty of time to do that. If I need to make more money, then I probably should upgrade it. But I'm definitely going to work on the pool, and then I'm going to start working on the upstairs. Because we're gonna need a gym. A gym? I don't know. Did I say... sorry guys, I'm all like tongue-tied. A gym. I meant a gym. What's this? Oh, we don't care. What else was I gonna put up here? That's right, VIP rooms. No, they're not called VIP rooms. You know, like the private suites. Master suites or whatever they call them. I may make a third story because I think we need a media room. Maybe the gym will go up here and the media room here. I don't know. That sounds like it could work though. And then upstairs we can put a couple of suites in there. So I'll see, but we definitely need a gym because people always complain about that. Okay, so we're definitely not making money right now. I just want to see something. View resort finances. See how we're doing. So, our expenses are $810 and our revenue is over 1,000 simoleons, so that's not too bad. Occupancy, we have 22 out of 25 people. What? There's no one here. This place is dead. Oh, okay, we have a couple people, but I don't understand why it says 22 out of 25. There's, like, no one here. One second. I just realized there is no trash can in here, and I don't want people making messes and all that, stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and add a couple trash cans because, you know, Sims, they can be major slobs, so... We don't want that. Not one bit. Okay, there we go. Random trash can right there. Okay. But yeah, so that's basically it for this resort. Clearly, it's not a very high-rated resort. It's only like one or something. Resort reviews. Oh, it's 1.5, whatever. So yeah, it's not good at all. But that's okay because it's new, so we get away with it. What's this? John Spencer? A date? No. Come on. He's married. God, Sims. Okay. That new island that we have, I still haven't done anything over there. I want to build another resort because I actually want these two to start as Resort Tycoon. That wasn't really my intention. I was only thinking like maybe two, but... Now I kind of want to just expand everywhere because why not? What is he doing? Play with Angelica? Oh, that's so sweet. Huh. I didn't know that you could play with the toys with them. remember that. But anyways, so we're definitely going to try to expand the resort business because it's taking off now that I have my first 5 stars, so why not keep going, you know? Okay, so stop washing the dishes. You're kind of being boring. Eat some fish because you're still hungry. And we're going to send her out. I think it stopped raining. Please yes, it did. I think a little windsurfing is in order. You, sir, can call the babies. You know what? He can work on his relationship with his daughter because she's best friends with her daughter and he's just like a good friend. In fact, compliment. That's nice that you want to compliment him, but he's busy. because I am going to have him teach her, teach her to walk. Because she ages up in 5 days, so we need to get this little girl moving. Okay, so Angela here, I feel like taking her out windsurfing. I don't know why. I wanted to take both of them out, her and Nathan, but Nathan really needs to just kind of focus on the daughter right now because she hasn't learned any skills, and we all know how long that can take. Wait, what's this? God dang it. I didn't even know that thing was broken. Okay, call repair technician, then we'll get out of the house. Goodness, there's always something. It never fails. It never fails. Every time, like, this let's play, the last split, there's always some kind of interruption. Okay, go windsurfing. And I find it so awesome that we don't have to buy windsurfers. I didn't know that when I first played this. And I bought them both windsurfers, and it turns out you don't need them to go windsurfing. So, honestly, I don't even understand that. Like, why bother adding an option in the game to buy them if you don't even need them to use them? So, oh, I guess if you want to customize one. Okay, that makes sense. Maybe that's why they do it. So you have your own personal, pretty-looking windsurfer. Okay, we're going to speed this up because mermaids in this game are freaking slow. Come on, get out there. Let's check on Nathan real fast. Forget the computer. Just work with your daughter. What's he doing? I told him to go teach her the law. Where's he taking her? I'm so confused right now. I don't understand what's going on. You better be teaching her the walk. No. I don't know what he's doing. God dang it. Teach her to walk. Okay. Let's go back to our girl here, windsurfing. Just having a blast. I actually want to get her back into the water and getting her to work again. Nathan here has a day off, but she's had tons of days off. She has not been working, like, at all. We need to earn a little over 12,000 simoleons to get to the next level in scavenging. Not scavenging. Sorry, I was reading her title for scuba diving, scavenging scholar. But the next level for being a diver. Because I've neglected her career way too much. And that tends to happen with unemployment careers. You kind of just, like, forget. Does she master windsurfing or something? The little thing, like, psh. I don't know what skill that's for. But whatever, so let's see. Is there a dive spot nearby? Why can't I move this? Okay, there we go. What is going on? Come on, game. Don't crap out on me now. Okay, yeah, just go to the mermaid grotto since it's closer. Just a boat here because you take forever to swim. Sorry. Don't be such a terrible mermaid. Maybe life will be easier. Okay, he better be teaching his daughter to walk or I'm going to throw a major fit. I will throw a rage fit. Okay, there we go. You better be teaching her to walk. Okay, good. Good. Isn't she cute? And then after she learns to walk, of course she's going to learn to swim. She's going to embrace her mermaid nature. And they'll just be one big happy mermaid family. Except for Nathan. He's not a mermaid. He's the oddball of the family. Even though he's technically normal, he's abnormal in this household just because. I don't know, maybe I'll wait off on making another resort, because you know what, now I think about it, the house is a little tight, even though there's only three of them. It's pretty tight. Like, maybe a bigger household, bigger houseboat would be a good idea. I don't know if I'd build one or buy one. I'd like to build one, but we're a little tight on money, so we'll just have to see how the resorts go. See how much we go rake in, and then figure out if we want to go for another resort, go for a brand new home. I don't know. I'm just kind of like in the mood to build some stuff, even though I'm a terrible builder. Make some pretty little houses. Okay, let's see. God, where's like all the collectibles and the fish and stuff? Is there seriously nothing down here? Wait, I see something. There we go. Don't run away from me. No! Don't worry, this let's play should not consist of me chasing around fish with my computer screen trying to click on them. Ugh. It's just like a pain in the butt. He keeps swimming away from me. It seriously is a pain in the butt though. You have to like pause the game every 5 seconds because when you go to click them and they're a little far off, or you're just like, you have your screen, camera, whatever, turn the wrong angle, they just swim right off. It's like, gah! Every time you try to click them, nope, too late. But hopefully we won't have to deal with that too much. Okay. She seems to be doing good. I want to see if I find a few more collectibles before we go back to Nathan, who better be. Okay, good. I'm just so afraid he's gonna, like, wander off and do something else. That's the problem with, Sims. Unless you turn their free will off, they just like stop what they're doing and go do something else and totally ignore your wishes. It's starting to get to the point where we don't control Sims, they control us, which is actually a very sad truth. Okay, I'm not seeing much of anything else. She's just like randomly. Look at that! Angelica just learned to walk. The world just became a little bit bigger for this little toddler. That is wonderful.
Murphy, yes.
That is so cool. I kind of want mom to teach Angelica how to talk though, since dad just finished the walking portion of it. And in the meantime, he can just, like, make some friends. You know what? We haven't talked to Triton in a long time. As long as Triton doesn't try coming on to his wife again, then all should be fine. Okay, what was he doing? Is he taking her to second floor? I don't know. We'll let him take her. And what is she doing? Oh, she's talking to someone underwater. I want to send her home and maybe work with the baby for a little bit. She's making friends. Huh. Has it really been so long since I've updated this Let's Play that I honestly don't remember the color of her shell bra? I thought it was a different color. Like, I didn't know it was this color. I just don't remember. Wow. Either I'm very forgetful or it's really been a long time. Which I apologize for, by the way. Just, I need more time. There needs to be more time in the day to work around school and Sims. But I guess all I can do is dream. And wait till the semester ends and hopefully have more time to update. Okay, here we go. Now we're starting to find more stuff. Maybe I won't be sending her home right away. Nah, you know what? I can just work on this off camera or whatever. She needs to go to her daughter. It's just that I wanted to kind of collect some stuff. Okay, let's go back to Nate. No, you and that freaking computer. That's all he wants to do. How about until she gets here, you work with her a little bit? And she's probably not going to get here in time. So maybe she'll teach Angelica to talk later. I don't know. I guess it's not too important because Angelica does have 5 days till she grows up. But I would like her to improve relationship with her daughter. I want the family to be really close together. So. Okay, so I'm sending her home. Big mistake. I forgot to make her boat here. Don't want her to swim. There we go. And let's see how much money we made. Tragic clownfish. That's cute. Oh, he's worth nothing. Siamese catfish is worth nothing. Clamshell, it's worth a little more. Hermit crab. Salmon. And of course, kelp. Which we're gonna keep for her to eat, actually. So, we made nothing. We made a couple hundred simoleons, but it really, really isn't anything much. Which is kind of sad. But, oh well. Okay. So she is home. And you know what? Since it's late, I think maybe she'll just attend to dinner. Wait a minute. They have leftovers, don't they? Maybe she doesn't have to cook. I'm feeling lazy. She's feeling lazy. Let's just go for... No, no, no. Actually, you can eat later. Let us go see what Angelica's up to. We're gonna cancel this interaction. We're gonna have her teach Angelica to talk. Circle. And Nathan here is going to kind of improve his relationship with someone. I think we're gonna go for the mermaid dude. Maybe, I mean, for right now, I'm keeping Nathan human, but if he does, whatever, if he does raise his relationship with a mermaid, like Triton or something, then, if I could get kelp from him, I will, and I'll probably make him a mermaid too, but for right now, I'm actually pretty content with him just being a human. I think it adds character and a little bit of this cute story. The mermaid falls in love with the, even though they're both humans at first, but whatever, whatever. Don't ruin my little fantasy thing. As far as I'm concerned, he just, like, found this mystical mermaid and fell in love with her. Even though that's complete bull, because, yeah. What's going on? Stop trying to eat. Dude, you have guest. Sims are the rudest. Oh my god, did you see that? I know I invited him, but usually Sims, like, wait outside for you to invite them in, they don't just barge for your door. Goodness, sir, what if we were indecent? Use your brain. Okay. Ask about scales? I don't think I've used this interaction. Let's ask about scales. That's funny. I honestly don't think I've used this interaction before. If I have, then... clearly, I don't remember. Okay, that didn't do much. I was expecting a little box to pop up with some little comment of some sort, but I guess not. Okay, no, we're not gonna boast, because Sims don't like that. Talk about beach safety. Talk about rescue story. You know what? Let's talk about beach safety. Let's bore the crap out of this guy.
Vordorp ni debelzob. Sagoob.
Oh, hey, he's not, like, annoyed. Usually when you do interactions like that, or tell long stories, or talk about a profession of yours, or something like that, the other sim gets really pissed off. At least that happens to me every time. Even if they have high relationships, it just gets so annoyed and pissed off. So this is the first time I've seen a sim just like, okay. I'm gonna talk back to you. Oh, awesome. They're actually hitting off pretty quickly. What else should we talk about? I don't know. I'm just gonna click random things. I don't want to click anything bad, though. Don't want to totally, like, bomb this relationship. No, we're not gonna flirt. Just, I don't know, chat with him. Okay, so I think the baby's got enough training. It's already, like, 9 o'clock. Just feed her on the floor. We're just gonna be lazy with this. Feed her now. Oh, stop crying, Nova. Come on, feed her. Don't neglect your baby. And speaking of you, you can eat. Okay, so now that we've taken care of that, we're gonna go ahead and get her into bed.
Simkadidi.
I think I'm just gonna have to work on her career off camera, because I understand that it can be kind of boring just watching me have her, you know, collect stuff underwater, scuba diving. Nothing interesting really happens. I mean, it was really cool to see at first when I first started Let's Play, but now it's just like, oh my god, enough's enough. I mean, I'm okay with it, but I'm sure people watching are like, stop doing the same things over again. Well, to be honest, I've done like mostly everything in this game, so it just kind of repeats. Right now, the only thing I really have left to do is just working on our resorts and improving their careers and basically just growing the family. Getting to see our little mermaid daughter grow up well, and that's pretty much what we're gonna be doing. So she needs her diaper changed. So I'm just gonna go ahead and bring this to a close. I would make this a little longer or something, or make a little more interesting one that I can already just like upload after this, but I really don't have time, unfortunately. I have homework to do, and then I have to go shoot myself. No, but I do have homework to do, and then I've got to get ready because I'm going to Halloween Horror Nights tomorrow. So I've got a lot to do, unfortunately. Except for the Halloween Horror Nights, I will admit I'm pretty excited for that. But anyways, guys, so yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and bring this to a close. After I find Crib. Angelica the bed. Okay, I'm used to saying crib. I don't know why they changed the words on that. What are you doing? Don't use a stroller to bring her upstairs. It's retarded. I'm taking that out of your inventory. You don't need that, girl. That's just stupid. Okay. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching. And I hope to see you in the next part. And of course, I hope to see you guys in my upcoming Sims 3 Into the Future Let's Play, which should be so awesome. Actually, I haven't pre-ordered it yet, but I'm going to do that. I'm going to do it right now before I log off. And hopefully I'll have the part up the day it comes out, or maybe even the night before, since people that download online get a little earlier. So yeah, definitely check that out, guys. And I promise you, it'll be a lot more interesting than this. This Let's Play is my first, so it's kind of just awkward now. But yeah, so check out Sims 3 in the future. University, which I need to continue, and I will. Just give me some time to kind of pick myself up and get situated, school and everything. And I will see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Bye!